Welcome to the Azure Red Hat OpenShift video series. I'm Andrea Bozzoni from the Red Hat Managed OpenShift Black Belt team, and here with me is Roy.
So I'm Roy. I work for Microsoft in the Global Black Belt team based out of the Netherlands. And today we're going to talk about use cases, innovative use cases. And when we start to think about what Azure brings to the table, what OpenShift brings to the table, and all the native integration that we see, there are actually some really cool use cases that we can think about. So what I always like to do is dream big and then even a little bit bigger. So if I can ask you, Andrea, if you dream big, what do you think about and what do you see as innovative use cases?
Yes, when I dream big, I dream for the customer. And if I think to the customer, what the customer really needs today, they need power because they want to deliver solutions like artificial intelligence, deep learning, machine learning, and scientific simulation. On this side, Azure gives to us the availability of the GPUs powered virtual machine. And on the other side, Aro has the capability to use this virtual machine in a simple way as a worker nodes in a cluster, in an Aro cluster. So this allows us to deliver this power when the customer needs in a flexible way, because you can set up an Aro cluster, add this virtual machine as a machine set, and use in a flexible way. In this way, all these things combined together give the flexibility the customer are searching for today to deliver this powerful solution. Shall I go to the lightboard and quickly explain to you how to create an Aro cluster with powered GPU virtual machine?
Please do.
Yes, I will. So let's see how to set up an Aro cluster with a GPU's machine set. So first of all, imagine that we have an Aro cluster with three master node and the classical three worker node setup. Then we create a different GPU's virtual machine, like, for example, Tesla V100 or P100, but there are available many more. And then with three steps, we are able to deliver this machine set, to add this machine set to the Aro cluster. First of all, we need to add the NVIDIA GPUs operator that take care of for us of all the complex stuff to install drivers, Kubernetes plugin on all these machines. The second step is to install the node feature discovery operator. That allow to Aro to discover all the GPUs on this virtual machine. And in this way, every workload can be targeted on this. And the last step is to deliver the workloads on this node. And that's it.
Thank you. That was amazing. It's really
Thanks.
Cool to see.
Yeah, it's really amazing. And if you would like to dream big, what do you think about?
Sure. So the way I think about it is we have a worldwide presence with Azure. Azure comes with more than 60 plus regions all across the world. So if you combine that worldwide reach in combination with Azure Red Hat OpenShift and then kind of capabilities on top of that, you can build all kinds of worldwide clusters. So let's, for example, take AMQ, right? A solution by Red Hat, a messaging broker solution. So what we can do over here, if we combine all the three flavors, so Azure, OpenShift, in combination with AMQ, we can actually build out a full-fledged global messaging platform. But shall I quickly draw that for you and tell you how that potentially would work?
Yes, could be really interesting.
Awesome. So I was talking about a global messaging platform. So first thing that I'm going to draw over here is the Earth, right? We have 60 plus Azure regions. So if you look at one of those regions, we have an Azure environment. So I draw one over here. But I want a second one and a third one. So I draw one over here and over here. And the cool thing is that with these Azure environments, I can choose the region where it needs to be deployed. And we have 60 plus, right? So this one is going to go over here. This one on the south. This one over here. Just as an example. Now, within those Azure regions, we're actually going to spin up an ARO environment. Easily done. You can use whatever language or tool you want to use and spin it up really fast, really quick. I'm just going to name one, ARO. Cool. But on top of that ARO, we can now also easily deploy, for example, AMQ. So we're going to deploy a custom workload. We call that AMQ. Do the same over here, obviously, but just pointing it to a different region. And over here as well. Now, super cool. I have three clusters, three AMQ instances spread across the world. So we need to make sure that these clusters can interact. And we can do that over the Azure backbone. But then we can actually do also some cool things over here and point this all to a traffic manager. And there you have it, a full-fledged integrated global messaging platform powered by Azure, Azure Red Hat OpenShift, and in this scenario, AMQ as well. I hope you enjoyed that.
Yes, a lot.
Cool. Any other use case that is on top of mind for you?
Yes, I think that the customer now needs also some tool, services, and application framework to deliver solution fast and to answer to requests of the business that every day are asking them, putting them under pressure to ask for new functionalities on their application. So for this, IBM develop software packages and tools like called IBM Cloud Paks that allow customer to use this kind that deliver to the customer services, application frameworks and tools in order to allow them to be more fast in the delivery of the solution. And this kind of IBM Cloud Paks can be delivered on top of ARO. For example, if you need to deliver an artificial intelligence or analytics solution, IBM Cloud for Pak for Data give you all the tools, the machine learning tools, the machine learning models to allow you to quickly deliver this kind of solution on an ARO cluster. And in this way, customer can concentrate on the business value and not on the things, the technical things that are behind of this. So this give they have the possibility to deliver quickly the solution that they need to release for the business.
Super cool. So what I'm hearing, ease of Azure, obviously,
yeah.
The ease of deploying Azure Red Hat OpenShift.
Yeah.
And now with the IBM Cloud Paks, we have full-fledged integrated solutions that we can just deploy on top of that so that the customer can focus on delivering business value.
Yeah.
That's amazing. I would love to get my hands on that and play around with it.
Yeah.
Cool. There is one other thing that I was thinking about, and that is about a low latency e-commerce platform. So what we know in the retail business and with an e-commerce platform is that you want to make sure that your customers have the shortest way to your platform when they're going to buy a product, for example. Because we also know, based on research, that if it takes longer than 3-4 seconds, they're probably going to go away and go to maybe the competition to buy that product, right? So what we are actually seeing with Azure Red Hat OpenShift and an e-commerce platform on top of that, and with all the advanced capabilities around networking, we can build those low latency e-commerce platforms. So think about Azure Front Door with a content delivery network, but also application acceleration, advanced network acceleration. And if you combine all those different things together, now you get a global scale, low latency e-commerce platform, guaranteeing you that wherever your customer is around the world, they will get the shortest path to your platform, buying your services or product, right? So I think Andrea and me, if we sit down for another night and we're going to think about it, we can think about many more, right?
Yes, there is a huge variety of workloads that can deliver on our cluster, for sure.
I fully agree. That was it for this video. I hope you liked it. We would like to challenge you to dream big as well. And if you have any questions, and you want to dream big together with Red Hat and Microsoft, feel free to reach out to your Microsoft or Red Hat counterpart. We are here to support you and help you. And we hope that you enjoy the other videos in this series as well. Yep. Thank you.
Thank you.